Yes? Sweet mother of double jeopardy backstroking and butterscotch. We're on our way.
Who was it? The Girl Scouts lawyers again?
That was the commissioner. You'll never guess which unduly famous TV personality made the most wanted criminals list this week.
Phyllis Diller? Gavin McLeod? Wink Martindale?
Close. Myra Stump, the darling hawk of daytime talk.
Myra? As in America's mom? The woman who told Tom Hanks to get a haircut? Surely you jest.
She's holding her audience hostage and giving them valuable gifts against their collective will.
I don't normally endorse the use of the word dastardly, but this is clearly dastardly, I think.
We've got to drive over to the station right away, or at our earliest convenience.
Great! I've been itching to bust some skulls since they canceled my so-called life.
Brady Culture's hair. It makes for an unwieldy but oh-so-enchanting memento of our first case in a long while.
He howled like a sick wallaby when I shaved it off him. Good times.
Anybody home? Guess not.
Going, Sam?
The TV studio.
Goody!
Well, here we are, Max. The TV station with programs too old to be contemporary, too new to be retro, but consistently derivative enough to be popular. WARP.
Television's so mindless, you can't help but watch.
Oddly quiet in here.
Mysteriously so.
Well, let's find this Myra character and smack some good old-fashioned sense into her.
I don't care if we smack it into her or smack it out of her, just so long as there's smacking involved.
You crack me up, little buddy. Stand aside, casually attired stagehand. We're Sam and Max, freelance police.
We've come to save some pathetic hostages from the clutches of...
Okay, I'm going to stop you right there. Number one, I'm not a stagehand. I am the director. The director!
Could have fooled...
Number two, we're no longer holding the auditions for animal cops with crippling mental disabilities and a lust for dance.
Oh no, we're not actors.
You got that right. I don't think I've ever seen worse acting in my entire life. And yes, I have seen Keanu Reeves' performance in Toast, the musical.
Sam, I think my hypersensitive ego may need stroking.
Don't look at me.
Next? Who's next?
You don't seem to understand. We're highly untrained police officers.
Look, hats off for dedication, guys, but I'm just not buying the police act.
I feel so invalidated.
We're looking for Myra Stump, the darling hawk of...
Do not mention that name in my presence.
Which name? Myra or Stump?
Either and or both.
What's your beef with Myra?
Let's just say Myra and I have creative differences. I'm creative and she isn't. I'm sorry, what was your question?
You and Myra. Why the hate?
Look, Myra runs her show her way, and I run every other show my way. If she doesn't want me on her set, I could care less.
You mean you couldn't care less. If you could care less, then you do care some, which doesn't really...
No, I was right. I could care less, because I care even less about what you're saying right now.
Oh, burn!
Quiet, knucklehead. What are you doing here, anyhow?
What am I doing here? I'm holding auditions for Midtown Cowboys. What are you doing here?
Midtown Cowboys? The critically panned but publicly adored sitcom about two cattle ranchers trying to make it in Midtown Manhattan?
Yes, well summarized.
You're hiring extras?
No, I'm hiring the stars. The two main characters went on Myra a couple days ago and I haven't heard from them since. I need replacements ASAP.
Sam, did you hear that? If we can pass one lousy audition, sitcom stardom will finally be ours!
Rocketing to fame for the most insubstantial of reasons. That truly is the American dream. We'd like to apply for that instant stardom you promised?
You want to audition? Well, if there were anybody else here, I'd tell you to forget it, but okay.
All right! What do we do?
I'm going to have you play a scene from Old Yeller. Tell me you've seen it.
I'm not into horror movies.
It's the classic boy gets dog gets rabies, boy shoots dog story. Max, I want you to play the boy.
Yes! Boy! That is so me.
And Sam, you play the dog.
Oh.
Okay, Sam, ready. I need you to act like you've got full-blown rabies. Understand?
What's my motivation?
You're a mad dog! Now, show me rabbit. No, Dig Dig. You should be just frothing mad. Cut! What are you doing? Sorry, I'm not hiring a dog who can't even do a simple rabidity scene.
I don't know what went wrong. I was feeling so rabid.
You look pretty disease-ridden to me.
Come back after you've taken a few thousand acting lessons.
Okay, so we clearly need something else. I'm not mistaken. Probably should go to the Oscars.
Maximilian?
What the?
You're probably wondering how I know your names.
Not really.
Psst. It's me, Bosco.
We want to buy something.
Quite so.
What have you got?
Well, there is still one can of shaving cream the blooming skin bodies haven't got yet.
Oh, yeah, I love shaving.
That's funny. I've never seen you shave.
I didn't mean myself.
And I have a most peculiar device behind the counter.
What peculiar device are you so eager to pawn off on us this time?
It's the latest in Bosco tech innovation. A delightful invention I like to call a chemical-based voice modulator.
Voice modulator? What's that?
I do believe it's self-explanatory.
We don't really have time to explain it to ourselves. Why don't you just explain it to us?
Well, it alters the frequency of your voice molecules. Very useful, very useful.
We'd like that voice modulator.
That would be 30 shillings.
Yeah, I left our shillings in my other pants. How much in dollars?
Let's see here. 30 shillings would be about 1 million American dollars.
$1 million? No way are we giving out that many tickets.
I think we'll have to find an entirely new revenue stream if we want that voice modulator.
Worth every shilling, trust me.
We'll take your last can of shaving cream, old chap.
Splendid, spiffy, tickety-boo. Just bring it to the counter.
Do you have any complimentary fresh garlic?
No.
Do you have any fine leather jackets?
No.
Do you have any gumballs the size of your head?
No.
Nothing for us right now.
Indeed.
Hands in the air, Bosco. You're coming with us.
Good heavens! What is the meaning of this?
We're taking you in for masquerading as a man of class and distinction.
What the devil? Surely you jest.
Yes, surely we do. On the bright side, now you can add the police to your long list of paranoia-induced nightmare subjects.
Pshaw, piffle, pish-posh.
Thanks, Bosco.
Hip, hip, honey nut cheerio.
I could use a shave.
I'll say. Your 5 o'clock shadow goes clear to your ankles.
Horsa, pig, dog, pig dog, the skin bodies rule the streets.
Blast, bugger, blimey, bally. The little bladder did it again. After him, I mean, tally-ho, fool.
Where are we going, Sam?
Hey!
The skin body sent me stuff!
After those rats! Do those laughably small wheels move so fast?
You'll never catch us! The skin body can't be stopped!
Take the wheel, little buddy.
I thought you'd never ask! Shoot him, Sam!
I'm trying, but they have good reflexes. Can't dodge my shots forever.
Watch it! The skin buddy can't be stopped.
Missed him.
The skin buddy can't be stopped.
Right, but they have good reflexes. No, sir.
The skin buddies can't be stopped.
Hey, the shaving cream!
Okay, hold on tight, little buddy.
Mommy!
I apologize for that drop in frame rate, but that was a little crazy.
Where are we going, Sam?
Send back to
the TV studio.
Goody!
Hello again.
Yes?
Can we take another crack at that audition?
Fine. Let's take it from the top. Ready, Sam? Show me Rabbit. Brilliant! Now that's what I call diseased.
Thank you. Thank you. First off, I'd like to thank all the little people who...
Zip it. Okay, Max, you just realized your dog is walking death, and you'll have to put him down for the good of society.
Really?
You're sad, you're despondent, you're grief-stricken. Now,
show me the emotion.
Boo-hoo?
You call that emotion? I've seen Myra show more emotion, and she ought to be declared a national Botox reserve. Grief, I said. Give me grief. Perfect. Now, the fateful moment has arrived. Despite your immense grief, you must put your beloved companion out of his misery.
Okay.
Uh-oh. Idiot. What demonic force possessed you to do that?
The demonic force called acting, Sam. You should try it sometime.
Good thing I had my anti-hypnosis helmet built into my head, or I'd have one too many holes in the head.
Bravo. Bravo! Such realism. Such authenticity. I was convinced you were actually shooting him. How did you do the sound effects?
You don't want to know.
The search for the Midtown Cowboys is over! You're hired. Head to the set next door and we can begin filming immediately.
Let's hurry, Sam! We only have 14 minutes and 55 seconds of fame left!
Hello again.
Yes?
I'm sorry, where's our sitcom being filmed again?
Actors, it's through the door to the right. Get over there.
See you later.
This conversation is a wrap. All right, people, let's get the stage set up. Celebrity host will be here any minute. Oh, right. The crew's working on Myra. Stupid, no talent, fat face.
All right.
Weren't you just...
I think she just defied the laws of physics.
Sorry, you'd be amazed how many times a day I have to do that. Things tend to be hectic here.
Doesn't bother us a bit. Sam and Max, consummate professional actors, reporting for duty.
You said duty, Sam.
I knew you guys were right for this show.
Speaking of which, could you perhaps explain the show a bit?
Okay, here's the drill. On Midtown Cowboys, you play a pair of cattle ranchers trying to raise a herd in an apartment in Manhattan.
My Uncle Ernie did that, except it was pigs, and not in an apartment.
I only see one cow.
It's a small herd. You're struggling, okay?
Okay.
You've got this landlord, Mr. Featherly, who has a very strict no-cows policy.
Devilishly inconvenient.
I begin to see from whence the hilarity sprouts.
Yes, Featherly is always barging in, and you try to hide the fact that you have a cow in the apartment. Lots of sight gags, usually something gross winds up happening. Simple enough?
Great. Where's the script?
Well, there's a slight hitch. The cow ate most of the script, so you're going to have to ad-lib the show.
Ad-lib?
Yes, make it up as you go. Improvise.
Well, I guess our regular life has given us plenty of practice.
Don't worry, you'll be working with Philo Pennyworth, who plays Featherly. He's a brilliant actor, classically trained, Globe Theater and all that. Just set him up to do something funny and he'll handle it from there.
Check. Anything else?
Actually, yes. We did save one line from the script, and it's really important to work it in, because it's the product placement that pays for the whole show. One of you will have to say the line.
Me! Pick me!
All right, Max. Your line is this. Better get the serious toothpaste.
I like it already.
Alright, this is really simple. All we need to do is to get Featherly to...
We're as ready
this,
as we're ever gonna be.
Goo.
Let's start taping the show.
Okay, now remember,
that's the
your
line.
Landlord's at the door, and you don't want him to know you've got a cow in there. Ready? Action!
They're probably hiding a cow.
Open up in there! I know you're hiding a cow!
Let there be light.
Hey! Open up! Open up in there! I know you're hiding a cow!
There we go. Life of the party.
Aha! I know you've got a... Well, well, well. Who's your guest, boys?
Hmm. This is the French chef we hired to satisfy our inexplicable, insatiable craving for omelets and duck a la one.
And frog's legs. I like mine extra crispy.
Oh, a French chef, eh? I love French bread and French fries. I went to Gay Paris one time myself, you know. It was back in my army days.
Goodness, who left this lying here? I don't care if it is just a prop. I'm not touching that with my bare hands.
Say, what's this? I'm sorry, what was that you said?
He said Camus. It's a very short French tone poem entitled The Pen of My Aunt is on the Dresser of My Uncle.
Except in French.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I'm just not sure where we're going with this. Can we start again?
Cut! Let's get the set back the way it was.
Okay, so clearly I screwed that up.
Let's have another go at that scene, shall we?
See if you can squeeze in some gross-out humor this time. Ready? Action!
Open up in there!
First of all, we need to grab the lampshade.
I know you're finding a cow!
Let there be light.
Hey!
And we put it on the cow.
Hey, bossy.
Open up!
Oops.
Open up in there! I know you're hiding a cow!
There we go. Life of the party.
Hey! Aha! I know you've got a... Well, well, well! Who's your guest, boys?
This is the French chef we hired to satisfy our inexplicable, insatiable craving for omelets and duck a la one.
And frog's legs. I like mine extra crispy.
Oh, a French chef, eh? I love French bread and French fries. I went to Gay Paris one time myself, you know. It was back in my army days.
Goodness, who left this lying here?
Say, what's this? I'm sorry, what was that you said?
He said mou gou gaipan. It's a French dish the chef has just made.
Whoa, super! I'll try some of that. Where's the plate?
I can't help but feel this is all terribly wrong somehow.
Interesting.
That's one word for it.
There's a familiar flavor. Fennel, maybe?
Kentucky bluegrass, I think.
This moo moo whatever stuff is really good. What's it called in English?
Cow pie.
Really? Well, that's funny. It sounds just like...
Now? Better get the serious toothpaste!
Zoom in. And cut. That was comical. The network is going to love it.
Naturally. I'll be in my dressing room refreshing my muse.
don't call me for at least an hour.
Nice work, you guys. Here's a clip for your reel.
Thanks.
Let's get the set back the way it was.
All right, we're going to call it there for part one, and I'll see you guys for part six. Or seven, rather, as it were.